is it? Dhoni does not accept it. Unless Dhoni say, I accept the gift, it is not a valid gift. The gift, whenever you write a letter for gift, please, I have made a gift, I will definitely sign it. But if the person who has received the gift does not put a signature there and saying that, I hereby accept the gift, it is not a valid gift at all. But this was movable. In the case of immovable property, the law of the land is, it must be registered. Stamp duty must have been paid. And then it is registered in the name of the donee. It is different in certain states. Only small amount is payable when you make a gift. In Punjab and in Haryana, you can pay only 2,000 rupees and gift can be made of any property to your blood relation. But in Delhi, it is not. You have to pay 6% or 8% to give a gift to somebody of immovable property. Immovable property, 8%. I don't know the position here that if you make a gift to your relative, is it immovable property I'm talking about? Movable property, there is no chance. Immovable property, there must be some stamp duty here. So gift is not valid of an immovable property unless the property is registered in the name of the donee and proper stamp duty has been paid. Clear, sir? Coming back. Government officers do not buy property either in their name or in the name of their spouses or the children. The reason is if they buy, they have to inform the department. If they have acquired any property above 50,000, they have to give complete details of those assets to avoid something. So normally they don't buy in their name. Nee, they have their own money. And they have earned it from known sources. Why should they not? But they don't have that much source also. No? You can't buy the property with your salary only. What kind of a salary? But they buy property. They buy property whose name? In the name of father, in the name of mother, in the name of in-laws, in the name of grandchildren, children allowed, spouse allowed. Am I right? That is also not allowed. See now, the next one. I will give in a negative tone. You can make it positive later. Property held in the name of brother or sister or lineal ascendant or lineal descendant shall be treated as a Benami transaction. I'll do something later to avoid that. But it is a Benami transaction. If I buy a property in the name of my mother, I buy in the name of my brother. I have not made a gift, please. Buy in the name of directly brother. Sometimes what I hate, I make a FDR of my mother's account, give money there. Put there, say. I buy a property whenever you are out of your state and you go to work elsewhere or maybe abroad. Normally, before marriage, I'm talking about before marriage, after marriage is very difficult. You buy property in the name of your mother or in the name of your father or sometimes in the name of your brother and sister also. These are all Benami transactions. These are all Benami transactions. They are all Benami transactions. Everybody is thinking, what will happen to me? Because we have also done the same thing. Wait. Sometimes I tell you. If you buy property in the name of brother or sister or lineal ascendant or lineal descendant, it will be called as a Benami transaction unless you are the joint holder in that property. And it is registered in your name also. Joint holder. You have to give your name also. If your name is not there and you have bought the property, you made a gift, that is a different thing. Gift, and then he buys, we are not concerned. Then income tax will come. But if I buy a property in the name of my mother, I have issued the check directly to the developer or to the seller, directly to him, it is a Benami transaction. I cannot buy property in the name of father or mother or brother or sister. This has been done because of government employees or politicians. They normally, I'm coming to that. 1 minute, I'll come to that. Who's asking? What I'm trying to say, property directly bought in their name. But if I have made a gift of money, and after making a gift of money, that money has been utilized for the purchase of that property, we are not concerned. We are not concerned. But we should not directly buy that property in their name. Maybe immovable or maybe movable. Somebody wanted to ask a question. I said lineal descendant. Son-in-law is not a descendant at all. Daughter is a descendant. Son-in-law is not a descendant. Lineal is state relationship. He is in-law. He is not otherwise a son. You can, but buying a property in the name of daughter or a son is otherwise not a problem. But you cannot buy in the name of a grandson or a great-grandson or granddaughter or great-granddaughter. But yes, you can make a gift to him or her, and thereafter she or he buys the property. There is no problem. But that should be a gift. But we don't give a gift. We normally pay the money abroad. Money is sent from abroad to the builder, and you give the name of your mother or name of the father or name of your brother or a sister. They're all Benami transactions. Intentionally done for government employees because they don't buy their name. And then if they make a gift, they have to inform about the gift also. They can't make a gift also of the property. Because if at all they gave a gift of more than 50,000 in a year, they have to inform to the department. We can save ourselves by saying that we had made a gift to the father or mother and then she or he had bought a property. But how will you prove it if the payment of check has already been given direct to the builder? You cannot do that. You cannot do that. First, put the money in their account, show that it is a gift, and then he can or she buy it, because income tax says gift to relative is exempt. But it is a gift. Gift of immovable property is only when it is in my name, then I only can give a gift. If I straight away deposit the money in the, or give the money to the builder, we can save ourselves by saying that we had issued a cross check and thereafter the check was endorsed by the mother. I have made a gift of money and not the gift of property. But please be sure, from 1st November 2016, do not buy a property in the name of your brother or sister or lineal ascendant or lineal ascendant, except of course the children and the spouse. It is Benami. You want to give? Give the gift first and let them buy it. Normally we put the money in the name of the mother, in the name of father, so that we created one more SSC. And income will exempt in their hands. Do it, I'm not denying. But first make a gift of money. And then put it there. If the immovable property, you can't make a gift. You have not the purchase. So first give the money and then gift it. So be careful about that. It is a Benami transaction. But if you are not a government employee, you can still save yourself by saying that we had made a gift and thereafter it was purchased. But in future, do not do anything. I'll first make a gift and then buy in their name. Because otherwise, there will be difficulty. It will be called Benami transaction. Any question on this? I'll have to come. Any question on this part? Or if you want to make a gift, you want to buy in their name, no problem. Put your name also there. That's all. Put your name. Even 1%, no problem. You should be a joint holder. That is the only thing. I am not saying that you cannot deposit in their account. Do it, but put your name. You can't buy in the name of your mother. Do it, but put your name also with that. Not name of your brother. Your own name should be there. Then, no problem. If you are a joint holder, percentage is not important, then it is not a Benami transaction. But if you are not a joint owner, even if it is relative, it is a Benami transaction. Clear, sir? Clear? Any? I think you want to understand this thing? Percentage is not important. Name. I said even 1%. I have no problem with that. They have not specified the percentage. They have specified the joint owner. That is a different thing. If you are giving to your brother or sister gift, it is otherwise exempt. Under 56, section 210, is it not exempt? Lineal ascendant, it is not exempt? It is exempt. I can make a gift to my father, where is the problem? I can make a gift to my grandson, where is the problem? But gift di jati which is genuine. In our country, nobody gives the gift, we take the gift. You give the gift to anybody, sir? You make a gift to anybody? You want to make a gift, I can take. And I will pay the tax on that. Try to make a gift to me. The gift are not given, gift are taken in this country. Nobody gives a bread to the brother or sister or anyone else. It's only the father-in-law, daughter's father, who has to make a gift. Other, who gives the gift? But here, Ramlal gives gift to Suleiman. What a national integration we have. Salma bhi makes a gift to Krishan Kumar. What a national integration we have. What a love and affection with each other. But now it is controlled because now it is a gift to relative. But still, by paying a gift of 30% tax also, people are interested in taking a gift. You want to make me a gift, I will have, take it, 30%. But it should be genuine gift, please. It should be genuine gift. And genuine gifts are not there. If you want to make a gift, I'm really happy. People are telling me, please get us a gift of any amount. We are ready to pay 30%. Because otherwise they are up to pay 78%. Thodi der mein batau. My point is, these days, gifts are selling for a premium. They are ready to pay 30%. I'm not talking about gift for my relative. I will pay 30%. Kindly make a gift to me. Because there will be no GST on that. There will be only income tax on that. And income tax is 30%. How does it matter? Everyone is interested these days in Modi's regime that they want to declare and pay 30%. Everyone is interested in paying 30%. But if you show income from other sources, in your return, you have it. You will have to pay 78%. Unless you are established the source of that income. If you are not able to give the source of income, 115 BBE, 68, 69, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D, tax will be 60%, surcharge 25% or 60%, 15%, 75%, 4% health and education cess of 75%, amounting to 78%. Gone are the days we used to say, put income from other sources. Now, put income from other sources. Give the source. Not able to establish? 69, 68, anything. And secondly, the GST people may also come. Kindly give the source. Because you might have saved GST on that also. 18% GST also. Be careful. Don't show anything as income from other sources in your return of income. Gone are the days. Gone are the days. You show it, you are not able to establish, pay 78%. What? A part owner, you can always be a part owner. I have not understood your question. What? If there is an asset, you have paid, huh?
A property of 1 crore.
Immovable or immovable?
Can be immovable. Okay. Immovable. And I pay on behalf of a third person. The beneficiary may or may not be me, but I pay the seller. A fraction of the asset price.
The fraction will be Benami, the balance also, will be his own.
So the
part owner, part also Benami. If you have given only 10%, the property, the extent of 10% is Benami.
But then the property cannot be, say, if it
who
is
said
a,
that?
Cannot be scrapped.
Who said that? 10% portion of that property can be taken away?
It's an indivisible property.
You think so? It is not. They can always do it. They can sell that 10% by taking a, right? They can do. Dekhi, I'm telling you, do not come out with anything like that. We have in Hindi called Hum Nahi Sudharenge. HNS. Change yourself. All eyes are on chartered accountants. All eyes are on chartered accountants. We have worked very hard to pass this examination. Everyone has worked hard to pass this examination. We will not let our clients to exploit us, let me tell you. 8th of November, demonetization took place. 9th of November, my office was full of my clients. Somebody said, I have 10 lakh. Somebody said, 20 lakh. Another 50 lakh. 1 crore. 10 crore. One gentleman came, I have 100 crore. I only asked one thing. Whenever I was asking for a fee, you were saying that, we are not doing well these days. If you are not doing well these days, how come 100 crore? How come 50 crore or 10 crore? The client does not tell you anything. You think he's telling you everything. He does not share. He shares only that much which is required to be shared. He doesn't tell. Don't take. He takes you for a ride. He takes you for a ride. He doesn't tell. He goes for a transaction, then comes to you, please save me. And we are business solution provider. And we provide for the patient. Sir, please don't take a risk of doing that. We are being victimized only for a person who is not bothered about us. He is not. If he had been bothered about us, he would have paid fees to me for first year fees. You have to do second year audit, then only you get first year fee also. And that too sometimes, you know, this is very much, too much. Please reduce it. Then what are you thinking? The client is for you. We are for client, he is not for you. Better are the lawyers who first take the fee and then they do the business. We are stuck with that. We are stuck that we are. He always tell you, you are a family member, you are a family member. You are just a family member. Well, we will give you the money. Sir, he is taking you right. He doesn't tell you all the things. When a search takes place and things come out, then had he told you that he has so much of things? He will never tell you. Even if a scrutiny case comes, he'll tell you only one thing. He goes away and you started feeling now he has to do the case. And he will not tell you many things. He'll give you a few papers and then we'll say, please get it done. Please get it done. He doesn't share. So please do not 100% believe your client. Today you don't sign his balance sheet. He'll go to some other. People come to me. Sir, I have to send money abroad. Please give me 15 CB. I said, please bring the agreement. Please bring the documents. Please bring the tax residency certificate. All this requirement for 15 CB. He says, sir, I have to send it today only. I said, nothing doing. Please give me the papers. I'll sign then only. He says, what are you doing, sir? You trouble law. He goes to another person who does not know ABC of internal taxation. He puts a stamp on that. It takes 1,000 rupees. What is this? Crores of rupees of the country is going abroad without tax deduction at source. Who is suffering? The country is suffering. The gentleman who has put his signature on that does not know any ABC of international taxation, and he has given that no TDS to be deducted on this amount, or only 10% to be deducted on this amount. Sorry, this is not to be done. Gone are the days when we could do it. Now, the entire responsibility is on the chartered accountant. I have stopped signing any form 3 CD. I don't do audit for the last 20 years. Tell me one 3 CD which is correct. Now he's not seeing me. Tell me one 3 CD which is correct. Who is responsible? We are responsible. Sir, first we have to save our life. Then only anything else. We cannot afford to miss this thing. We will earn less, but we will not do any wrong thing now because of computer age. Computer age. Your balance sheet in your computer made of the client, which has been changed 3 times, figures removed from here to there or there, if it is caught, who will be responsible? We will be responsible. It is in our computer, things have been changed. So please don't take a risk. Things are different. Those days when there was no computer, we could take out papers, we could put in papers, you know all that, I don't need to tell you anything. Now it is not possible. MCA, how many papers you to take away, how many papers you used to, but they give there. Now can you change anything in MCA? Absolutely no, all online. And wait and watch. We are going to have e-assessment very soon in there. What we are recommending, we will learn, I'll tell you some later, you will say, can this happen? It is dream selling, we are going to do it for e-assessment. Neither the department wants it, nor the chartered accountant wants e-assessment, let me tell you. But it is going to come. So wait and watch. Please do not think of an alternative now. What is correct is correct. What is wrong, tell them wrong. I have lost my business. I was giving a lot of opinions. People used to come to me for opinions. Opinion for future planning, opinion for historical done. I have given them opinion for historical. I have stopped giving opinion for future because the moment I give that opinion, they will say, you are the responsible person who has given them this advice to go for this type of a transaction. I'm so scared of this gentleman that I have stopped wearing the suit. I'm wearing the Modi jacket, tell me hello. I have stopped, so did he. So please believe me, I am interacting with everyone. Their intentions are now to go after each and every chartered accountant who is doing wrong things. And three disciplinary committees or four are made in institute, and the next is NAFRA coming. NAFRA also is coming. So please, we will earn less, but we will not do wrong things now. Gone are the days. So do not plan wrong things. Tell them, pay tax and enjoy life. Pay tax, and people are ready to pay tax. These days, they are all ready. They'll come to you, say, I want to show the money. Please pay tax 30%, I'm ready. I said, now this is not the time to pay 30%, pay 78%. Otherwise, wait for some time. We will bring down to 30%, then show it. But we had given the IDS also. Nobody bothered to do IDS. There was a black money, nobody bothered to do that. There was a demonetization, nobody bothered. Now everyone is scared of that. So please be careful, I'm coming back. So, A is over, held by him, consideration given by me for my immediate or future, direct or indirect benefit, correct? Four exceptions, one, HUF, two, fiduciary capacity, three in the name of a spouse or child, four in the name of brother, sister, lineal ascendant, provided I am joint owner. These are the four exceptions. I'll tell you rest later thing. Now, next point. Clause B. Benami transaction is a transaction or an arrangement. In respect of a property, it is a transaction arrangement in respect of a property where the Benamidar is a fictitious person. Benamidar is a fictitious person. You have bought an asset in the name of a person who does not exist. His bogus name, fictitious name. So that is a Benami transaction. You meant to buy it in the Ram Lal, Sham Lal, whatever.